Denver police shot 6 bystanders and an innocent black man who was completely complying. When I tell you this looked more like an attempted murder than some normative police action, that's an understatement. Let me take you to the video. Here it is. The police are looking for individuals who were involved in a fight. They find an African-American male. They believe he's armed. He puts his hands up immediately. He throws the gun away. The gun is in the air. See there? It's in the air. And they still shoot him. So even if he thought, well, maybe I was in danger, why did he continue to shoot the black male when the gun was now solidly on the ground? In addition to that, another officer on the side of this victim started shooting at him as well. No gun. The black male had no gun. His hands were up.
So we have the girls on the other side of the alley who shot in the back.
I see.
So okay. This ambulance is going to take the girl with the leg and the guy with the arm.
Okay.
And then the ambulance that's right there is going to take the guy with the one in the back.
Keep
Might be in that area or
for no reason.
On the right side of that white SUV, right here on the right side. Take one more
lap. Police keep killing us.
What you just saw was a mass shooting defined by the FBI. The FBI says a mass shooting is when 3 or more individuals are shot at the same time. What you just saw was Denver police engaging in a mass shooting against citizens. I want you to think about the context here. It's bad enough if you shoot at someone and you hit one innocent bystander. They hit 6. All 6 of them could be dead, including Mr. Waddy, the black male who was unarmed at the time of the shooting. Now remember, they lied on their initial report about what happened. That's a violation of oath of office, right? That's illegal, completely illegal. The black male, this brother is alive, but he could be dead. He was shot multiple times, no weapon. He threw it away. And why is it that all of a sudden an American citizen with a gun causes such alarm? Why is it that if a white male had a gun, he would be considered patriotic, but a black male who had a gun, they started to target him? Let me give you the background. Denver's district attorney says that she is now opening a grand jury investigation into the actions of 3 police officers who wounded 6 bystanders while shooting an unarmed suspect in a crowded downtown Denver nightlife zone last month. So this DA, I gotta say something, because the article does not point it out. This DA initially decided, well, there's nothing to see here. It wasn't until the video came out, the video that we assume was seen by the DA's office. Once that video came out to the public, that's when this DA said, we're gonna now investigate. The officers had already been placed on administrative leave while pending a separate internal investigation into the shooting, which took place on July 17th, which happened as dozens of patrons left bars that were closed for the night in the city's lower downtown neighborhood. Once again, the person this happened to is Mr. Jordan Waddy, okay? And as I said before, he's expected to survive. The public's interest in this particular shooting incident is understandably high, the DA said, Beth McCann, announcing the new investigation on Tuesday. For the community to trust in the outcome of this incident, it is important that independent members of the community review the facts, evidence, and law regarding whether these officers should be criminally charged. What? Excuse me? Who? independent members of the community review the facts. Madam, that's why you were elected. You were elected to prosecute crime, not to hand it off to some committee to make a recommendation because you don't like the political entanglement. Be a leader, madam. You were willing to let these cops go with what looked to be attempted murder. Definitely negligence, criminal negligence here. You were willing to let it go until it became public. Now, you don't want to simply make an example of these cops. Madam DA, let me say this to you. Somebody make sure she gets this segment when we post it. If, I don't know, let's say the Crips, the Piru Blood, would have engaged in activity like that, shooting individuals who are complying, shooting innocent bystanders, you know, that's called a drive-by. You would have had a press conference that day, Madam DA. You would have said, we're going to make an example of these thugs in our community. But when those thugs put on a uniform and a badge, all of a sudden, your leadership decreases. Police have said the three officers whose names have not been made public fired 7 times in the confrontation with the suspect, Jordan Waddy, who police say was armed. That's what they said in the police report, that he was armed, he was dangerous, he drew down on them. What did you see in the video? You saw a man tossing a gun away. You saw a man trying to live. You saw a man who got shot even after the gun was on the ground. The gunfire erupted as a nearby group of partygoers left the bar, gathered at a food truck. The officers were following Mr. Waddy, 21 years of age, after they saw him punch another man during a fight. Now, the witnesses say they were involved in mutual combat, all right? Body cam footage released by Denver police on Tuesday appears to show Waddy holding a pistol and throwing it to the ground as the officers opened fire. Police previously said Waddy was holding the firearm before the shooting. At least one officer shot at Waddy while facing a crowd of people gathered behind the suspect. The footage shows when the shots were fired, the crowd scattered. Some people fell to the ground in a rush to escape, and others ducked behind the food truck or crawled on all fours. Now, let me ask you this. If you were in that crowd, right? Who's the public safety threat to you? Is it Mr. Waddy? Is it the fight that took place or the police? What element was the most critical public safety dynamic? It was the cops. Mr. Waddy, who suffered non-life-threatening injuries, was arrested still on suspicion of felony menacing, suspicion, and possession of a handgun by a previous offender. Court records said he is represented by a lawyer from the public defender's office, which does not comment on cases. 6 bystanders were injured, and authorities have said all received hospital treatment for non-life-threatening injuries. The police are now engaging in mass shootings in the United States of America. I know no one died. Their lives have been turned upside down. They will have physical disabilities for the rest of their natural lives. But they all could be dead, every single one of them. All right, Yasmin, thoughts on this case?
Yeah, it's funny. I'm actually leaving to go to Denver as soon as I'm done with this show. Wow. I have my bag packed and I'm heading out that way just for the weekend. But what's interesting about this is what you said. You know, it is confusing whenever you have cops who are shooting the people, and then we're also afraid of mass shooters, and the cops are supposed to protect us from those people. It's a bit of a conflict of interest, or at least it's very confusing to the public. And then we keep hearing, especially from the Back the Blue faction, that people should just comply with the cops' requests whenever they're dealing with the cops, whenever they're in a certain kind of situation. And now we even have like TikTok content creators who instruct people on how exactly to comply with the cops' requests in an effort to prevent misunderstandings, communication breakdowns, ultimately situations like the one that we just saw. But still, it shouldn't be so difficult for public servants, which is what cops are, to interact and engage with ordinary citizens. There has to be some sense of humanity when approaching these situations. It's people dealing with people, but the thing is, things get complicated when you introduce deadly force or interactions between people to these interactions. But that's what cops are supposed to be trained to do. They're supposed to be trained to deal with these situations in a way that de-escalates any potential danger rather than exacerbates it. But unfortunately, that's not what we're seeing. And this is really just kind of an egregious overstep of just the failure to do that.
Yeah, these cops need to be arrested. They need to be charged with felonies. And we need to see the wheels of justice turn much quicker. I think it's interesting to note that none of these cops have even been held responsible for the lies they told on the police report. The video evidence clearly contradicts the police report, which now becomes another criminal charge.